live from Adore. It's just been an incredible show and time here so far. We're just blessed to be joining us now, Wendy Ross. She's the superintendent of the Theodore Roosevelt National Park. Literally, what, maybe 200 or 300 yards away from here, yes?
It literally is, 200 or 300 yards away from us here.
So I got to ask, you hear so much about national parks. I personally, unfortunately, have not spent a lot of time in them. So what's the draw? I'm going to go there this weekend. What kind of things should I be looking for?
Well, it's an amazing place. As you can see from just Medora, the buttes around us are this incredible landscape of Badlands. It's an erosive landscape, so it's very dramatic. It's changing all the time. And we are so lucky to be right on the edge of Medora. So our visitors get this great experience in the town of Medora. As you saw with our president here, he's giving everybody that history of Theodore Roosevelt. And then you can just travel into the park right down this road. You go into the park. There's a loop road that is closed, just about 5 miles of the loop road is closed right now, but you can certainly go in and travel about 24 miles of the loop road. The bison herds are out, so you can be on the lookout for bison herds. We've had antelope sightings in the park, and the young antelope are out, so keep your eyes open for antelope. Deer, of course, are in the park and also in the town of Medora. And sometimes you get to see a bighorn sheep. Those are more often seen in the north unit, but that is a
special. So there are hiking trails you can go in and walk around and see all this? Or?
Absolutely. We have hiking trails from about a quarter of a mile that is good for beginners, or longer hiking trails that you can get information at our visitor center, which is just right here in Medora. Our rangers at the visitor center can point you in the right direction, give you all kinds of tips, and they can send you in the right direction for what you want to see. But one of my favorite trails is the Petrified Forest Trail. And that is just outside of the park a little bit. You drive to a trailhead, and you can do about 12 miles up there.
Wow.
It's a great trail. And what we really encourage our visitors to do is to bring a lot of water. We have rescues all the time of visitors that don't take enough water. And as you see this morning, the wind is kind of blowing. It is evaporating all of our moisture in our bodies, and the local landscape gets really dry. And those are the best hiking conditions that you can have this time of year. So if you're out hiking, we want you to bring enough water. We want you to know your route, so bring your map and really get to know the Badlands the way that Theodore Roosevelt did.
You touched on this, but it's just really important to get outside, enjoy this national treasure. Get outside of city limits sometimes. We get lost in our busy lives and inside the city. This isn't too far away for people to get outside and enjoy a national treasure.
That is so true, Lisa. And I really encourage people to get at least a mile off of the beaten path. Theodore Roosevelt would have traveled these Badlands. Probably every square inch of the Medora area would have been explored by him. And if you get off of that beaten path and you get away from people, incidentally, this is one of the least visited national park areas. One of the things that we had in a visitor survey revealed was that people feel great when they come into this park and don't see a lot of crowds. So this park is known for not having a lot of crowds, a lot of people, kind of congestion. So I think people enjoy that. And if you get off the beaten path, you probably won't see many visitors at all.
Are you going to take a trail today, Budo, and go see some
maybe,
bison? Maybe.
I want to get out there and kind of enjoy, you know, seeing. I'm glad you talked about the bison.
Yes.
And the antelope, because that is something that they're just doing their thing, whether you're hiking, walking, or driving. You often get to see the animals, correct?
Correct. And that is one of the things that our visitors really look for is wildlife. Stay a safe distance, of course, 25 yards at least. And if you're impacting that wildlife or they're moving because of you, you want to step back just a little bit. But look for bison babies in the park, and also other babies of wild horses.
Yeah,
yes, the wild horses. And antelope, as I said, and the baby sheep as well. So enjoy your time here.
So much to see. Thank you so much. You have to go to the national park if you come out to Medora, for sure. All right. Thank you so much,
Wendy,
for your time. Stay with us. We coming up next, we have your daily motivation, and of course, it's going to come from the president himself. We have another great quote.